some healthy recipes, and my husband and I are having meatballs and rice tonight, so that's what y'all are gonna get. I'm gonna walk y'all through the steps of some healthier meatballs and rice. I'm using long grain and wild rice here, and we're gonna do a spicy meatball with a sweeter rice. And what's gonna make our rice sweeter is these Vidalia onions here. So first I'm gonna brown the rice. And I don't know what it is, but that just seems to bring out a better flavor to me. I've done it both ways, and I prefer the browning. Yes, I am gonna get a little bit of butter. A little bit of butter is not gonna hurt you. And it is better to use the real stuff. Don't use margarine. Don't use spread. I'm not telling you not to use what you want. I'm just telling you that butter is not as bad for you as you think it is. Do your research. Don't get that. If you do, that's just going to have to be cut out. Okay, I'm letting the butter melt. I've got it on about medium. Okay, now that the butter's melted, I can go ahead and add the onion and the rice together. Brown them both together, killing two birds with one stone. If y'all have never had Vidalia onions, you need to get some and try them. They also make amazing blooming onions, I've heard. I haven't had any. But my husband loves them, and I've heard many other people say that they are yummy. And I do love Vidalia onions. Such a mild, sweet flavor. Okay, adding the rice in with the onion. While that is browning, I'm gonna go ahead and start adding the ingredients of my hamburger together. So I have my hamburger here. That's what I'm using for the meatballs. And these are gonna be spicy. Let's see. First, let me go ahead and add my binder. I'm going to add 2 eggs. To help hold them together. I'm going to add some panko breadcrumbs. Use whatever brand you like and whatever flavor you like. These are just plain. I'm not adding a lot. I probably added not quite half a cup to the hamburger. Again, just to help hold it together. I don't add too many breadcrumbs because I am trying to avoid a ton of starch. Just enough to be able to hold it together. Help it hold together some. I'm going to add some minced onion. I didn't want to add any more Vidalia onion to the meat because that's going to be enough sweet for that. So add a little bit of minced onion, and again, you adjust this to your liking. This is how I like it. This is just one recipe of many that you can do for meatballs. I do like having real garlic, y'all, and everything. We are out, so it's got to be your bottle of garlic powder. I'm just stirring this rice and onion so that it doesn't burn, but that it browns nicely. Babe, you wanna come get a look at this rice? I'm adding a little bit of paprika to the hamburger. Now here is a trick that a lot of y'all are gonna love. I want a little bit of a sausage flavor to the meatballs, so I'm gonna throw in some sage. And it's not gonna pour quick enough for me. I'll take this top off halfway up. And yeah, I do know that is a bit of sage, I know. Okay, y'all know that I'm doing a low sodium diet, so I would love to do Frank's hot sauce. That's a salt bomb. I wish I could. So we're gonna use sriracha and red pepper flakes instead to give it its spice. to fool my brain into think I'm getting some salt, I'm going to use a little bit of liquid smoke. And that, though it doesn't taste salty, it almost fools your brain into thinking that you are getting somewhat of a salty flavor. It does work. I've tried it. This is not my first time. And the rice is browning up nicely. Okay, y'all. I use curry in so many things. It has turmeric in it, and that is great, great, great for anti-inflammatory. For inflammation, rather, but it is a great anti-inflammatory, natural
curcumin
thing for
curcumin.
Curcumin for, thank you, baby, for inflammation. And anyway, I've just gotten to where I've always really liked the taste, but right now I'm just in love with the taste. And it probably won't stick with me forever. I go through phases of loving certain flavors and wanting everything. And right now it's a curry thing. So I'm gonna add that curry to the meatball. That's also gonna add just a little bit of heat. Add my oregano because, yeah. I'm using long grain and wild. It is better for you than the totally stripped of nutrition white rice. And obviously better for you than brown rice from what we saw in a video today.
Got some honey.
Yeah, sure, why not? My husband just suggested honey and I think it might be a pretty good idea. But where's the honey? I'm adding the red pepper flakes, and that was a little bit more than I wanted to add.
I think it's up there.
Taking off my wedding rings. I don't want to get meat all in them. Oh, yes, honey. Let's add a little bit of honey. But only a little. This is a real... Y'all think honey is better for y'all than sugar, and nutritionally it is. Calories? Or actually, honey's got sugar beet, calorie-wise. I'm going to step off camera for a second just to wash my hands. Looks delicious, huh? Yeah, not so much right now. Okay. Most of my onions are at about a see-through point, which means they're good and sauteed. I think I'm only going to let this fry for another few moments. In the meantime, I'm going to get my frying pan ready for these meatballs. We are going to fry these in some olive oil, not butter this time. Okay. You want to come get a shot of this? So I can know about what to fry it to if they choose to do so. So this is how my rice is looking. You see most of it's brown. You can see through most. The onions are taking on an opaque light quality. They're not white anymore. They are looking opaque. So I'm going to go ahead and add this water. Put my lid on. This is 2 cups of water to 1 cup of rice. I will add my spices at the end when it's done. I'm going to turn that down on just about low. Put my lid on. And that's not the correct lid. Let me see. Okay, so I could not find the correct lid for this. I know it exists somewhere. We're just going to use this and deal with the water hitting the eye, and it'll be fine. I'm heating my oil up in my frying pan, getting ready to brown my meatballs. So I'm going to start making the meatballs with my hands. Yes. If you have any cuts in your hands, don't use hot sauce, sriracha, or anything like that. Or use gloves. I'm My husband is so wonderful in that just about everything that I do or feel like needs to be changed or done, for whatever purposes, he just goes right along with it with me. And this is just one example. Salt-free, eating healthier, and he does not have to do this, but he does, and it really does make life a lot easier when you don't have to watch your partner eating all of this stuff that you can't have anymore, that you wish that you could have. All right, I've just about got all of that good and incorporated, and there's no reason to wash my hands because I'm going to make a meatball. You do want to wait until your oil is hot, but not about to catch on fire or burn. But you want to make sure that it's hot so that your meatballs, so that they're not soggy, so that they don't absorb all of that oil and become soggy. Okay. I just kind of hover my hand over to see if I can feel the heat, and I don't. So I'm going to wait another minute or so. Okay, the oil feels like it's just about hot enough, so I'm going to go ahead and start making my meatballs and putting them in. And I'm going to make them kind of small because we normally eat dinner earlier than this, and I'm hungry. Are you looking?
Mm-hmm.
Oil is not quite hot enough, so I'm just going to set the meatball to the side right now. It felt kind of, it is sizzling a little bit, so it is about pretty. Okay. So I'm just going to wait just a few seconds, let it get just a little bit hotter. Alright, I'm adding some of the meatballs to the frying pan. Yep, they're sizzling nice now. I'm trying to think of a cute little story or something to share with y'all while I'm cooking this for y'all. And right now, for the life of me, I cannot think. I feel like I'm not braining very well these last couple days. It's been a little bit of a difficult weekend with a dear friend of mine. And I feel tired. But I also feel hungry. And I wanted to share this with y'all. So here we are. So I've got all the meatballs in the frying pan. I'm going to start with the first one and just start rolling them so that they get brown on all their sides. If they're cooking too fast, turn it down a little. If it seems like they're not cooking fast enough and they're getting kind of soggy, turn up your heat a little bit. I'm going to go all around. I'm just browning the outside. I'm not trying to make the meatballs get all the way through right now. That will come later. Just browning them right now. Y'all, even though it's been a rough weekend, I did make it to the gym today. And I did strength training on my upper body and my arms. And in all honesty, I don't know if I'm going to be able to move my arms tomorrow. They are a bit shaky, tired, but that's okay. No pain, no gain, right? Okay, I'm going to grab, baby, can you grab me that cream colored spoon? Right there, a slotted spoon. I don't want to take any of the olive oil out. Okay, I'm going to start taking these meatballs out. I'm just going to leave them on this plate. This is a plastic. Leave them on this plate. Not to drain. I don't mind the olive oil. Just sit there while I do all of the meatballs. And we're going to repeat this process until that whole entire thing of ground beef is made into meatballs.
Pause.
Okay, welcome back, y'all. We were gone for a few minutes while I browned these meatballs. I didn't want to bore y'all with the whole process. Y'all saw how to get it started. I'm sure that you can get it done. I know you can. I have put into my frying pan after my husband dumped the grease that come off the hamburger meat. The meat was lean. It still had some grease on it, though. So I did not want to have that in the sauce. So my husband dumped the grease. I now put in a small can of tomato paste, which I scrape out with my handy dandy butter knife. And I also put in a very small can of tomato sauce. I'm going to thin this down with some chicken broth. I normally like to make my own chicken broth, and I might even have some in the refrigerator. I don't even think about looking. But anyway, that's what we're thinning that tomato paste down with to add more flavor than just water. It is reduced sodium, y'all. So, I'm still being good. That's not good. That, some of that nonstick come up there. Consistency of my sauce. Again, y'all can have it however you want. This is just how I want it. I know it's going to cook down some. Okay. Now, I know I'm going to catch heck from a lot of y'all on this, but I've cut out sugar. I've cut out salt. I cannot give up all sweet. Maybe someday. It is a goal, but I do use artificial sweeteners right now. And so I'm going to use a little bit of sucralose in this tomato here. If you don't use some sort of sweetener, some form, you're going to have a bitter flavor in many, many of your vegetables. Definitely tomato, your beans, your peas, many of them. You've got to use a little bit of sweetener of some kind. So there's that. Yeah, I'll hear it. If I don't hear it from you, know that I already know. I know. A little bit of olive oil. Some more oregano because, yeah, oregano. Dogs are at the floor. Please, please, can we have some meatballs? No, you may not, not right now. Garlic. I want this to taste a little like a marinara. That's what I'm going for. Some minced onion. And then, I meant to tell y'all, I did turn off the rice just because this cooked a lot quicker than I thought that it would, and we really need to get this going. I haven't tasted it. We did have to add some more water because this isn't the proper fitting top, and the water evaporated quicker than it should. But I'm about to switch the lid from here to here and give the rice a taste just to see how much longer it may need to cook. All right, adding the meatballs into the sauce. Gonna stir the meatballs to coat them in this, and then we're gonna sim them until they're done. If they break up a little bit, which mine haven't so far, but I'll be surprised if they do. It's fine. You're not cooking for a restaurant or anything like that. They don't have to be perfect. They just have to be delicious. Okay. I'm going to let those simmer now. Now that's the perfect fit. All right. Stir up my rice. I'm thinking it's not done just from the stir. The stir feels a little, I don't even know how to this. I have not added my seasoning to the rice yet.
No, actually it's perfectly done. I was wrong. Okay, I'm just gonna let that sit and then add the seasonings when everything is done. So we'll be back soon. Welcome back. Our meatballs and our rice is done. I decided I am just gonna add a little bit of curry to the rice and call it a day. Now, there is some oil on top of these meatballs, and I do suggest that you drain it off with a spoon. But right now, I'm going to go ahead and try some of this to see how it turned out. I think I'm going to add a little bit more curry than that. Yes, y'all. I love curry. All right. Again, y'all add whatever spices that y'all want. There's so many variations to this that you can do. I mean, it's endless. This was just kind of thrown together on the top out of the top of my head. Okay. I got a little bit of rice and one little meatball. We'll taste this, make sure it's right, and then we're gonna sit down for some dinner. My husband and my son. I'll try this first. Let y'all know how it is. Oh, it looks really hot. That is actually really good. I hope that y'all try it for yourself and enjoy it. Let me know what you think. Thanks for watching.